עיריית ירושלים, אמיר ברקת, שגריר אבי פזנר, שהיום היושב ראש של יריד הספרים, מיטב ברכותיי לך, השופטת דליה דרנר, שעמדה בראש ועדת השופטים שקבע מי יקבל את הפרס, הסופר אנטוניו מונוז מולינה, כבוד לראותך כאן, שגרירים, חברי כנסת, אורחים, קהל נרבד. חשוב לי להגיד כמה מילים קודם כל בעברית. כפי שכבר הוזכר כאן, יריד הספרים נוסד לפני 50 שנה. במשך 25 שנים ניהל אותו ועמד בראשו איש שלעולם לא נשכח את תרומתו, זאב בירקר, עליו השלום. תרומתו של זאב היא חד פעמית. בערים גדולות בדרך כלל מתפרעים בקתדרלות, בפסלים, במונומנטים אחרים. הוא החזיר לישראל ולירושלים את המונומנט הכי גדול שיש לנו, הכבוד לספר. ועשה את ירושלים שוב, בירה של ספר, של ספרים, של סופרים. ואחרי טדי קולק הוא העניק לה תרומה ייחודית, שעומדת בזכות עצמה. יהי זכרו ברוך. Dear friends, if I were asked what my ultimate, most grandiose dream would be, I would say this. For Jerusalem to be a capital of books, literature and authors. The heart of a new peace in a new Middle East. And an academy of galloping science. Even in the age of Facebook, in Jerusalem, you can still read a book. As we know, Jerusalem has no sea. Literature, in my eyes, is in a way a sea filled with wisdom instead of water. Wisdom has its own depth, its own waves, flirting with the winds and carting undiscovered ground. I was asked to talk about books, but when I read Sefaradim by Antonio Muñoz Molina, I was struck with an unbelievable, forceful encounter. It touches on subjects from the most penetrating aspiration in life to the noble and hidden elements which lay deep, soul wandering in our genome. A chapter which moved me almost to tears is the one entitled Those That Wait. I found it poses fundamental questions, and let me quote and quote. What would you do if you knew that any moment they could come for you? That your name would be already on a typed list of prisoners, or future dead, or suspects, or traitors. Maybe, right now, someone has penciled in a mark beside your name, taking the first step in proceeding, that will lead to your arrest and possibly your death, or to the immediate necessity of leaving the country, or temporarily merely, to the loss of your job, or of a certain minor perks you would find it too hard to give away. These are not only penetrating questions regarding Nazis, fascists, communists, or dictators devoid of any ideology. But these are questions that hover our heads in an air counseled to the eye. Germans that breathe inside us, Germans that breathe inside us, which at first glance seem like the loss of certain minor perks you wouldn't find hard to give away, as the author writes. They are invisible, so tiny, and yet so menacing. And we are unaware of them. We don't ignore their presence, but yet we don't count on their existence as well. Then I continue the quote. You're not an isolated person, and do not have an isolated story, and neither your face nor your profession nor the other circumstances of your past and present life are cast in stone. The past shifts and reforms and mirrors are unbreakable. Every morning you wake up thinking that you are the same person you were the night before, recognizing an identical face in the mirror. But sometimes in your sleep, you have been disoriented by cruel shards of sadness and unslept patience that cast a muddy, somber light on the ground. And the face is different, changed by time, like a seashell drowned by the sea. And the pounding insult of the sea. This is the end of the quote. For me, a born Ashkenazi, those were questions and warning that emerged from an unbelievable Sephardic treasure, as seashells from the great human ocean. In that ocean, there are many other pearls, but even those that I've quoted had made me already a wealthier person than I had been forever. I want really to thank you for this gift, for this occasion. Those are great questions and great remarks that still hang over our life unanswered, and we have to be aware of them. Thank you very much.